People often ask me, why should we care about coral reefs? Corals build one of the most important ecosystems in the ocean. They are animals, but they look like rocks because they make a skeleton underneath themselves and they leave it behind as they grow up toward the sun. And then that creates homes for sponges and clams and snails. And those smaller organisms are what feed the bigger fish and the bigger fish. So without the corals, you slowly lose the ability to support the entire pyramid. People often don't realize that they help protect the shorelines from waves, from big storms and from hurricanes. We know that corals can live for a long time, but what's particularly interesting about that is that they're living in the blazing hot sun near the equator for hundreds and hundreds of years. So now scientists are looking into how a coral manages to repair its DNA when it's sitting in the blazing sun for decades and decades, and hopefully we can understand how to prevent the mutations that eventually lead to cancer in humans. Corals live with algae in their tissues. It would be as if you had lettuce growing under your skin and you were able to use the calories that that lettuce was making without eating any food. When a coral bleaches, the balance between that algae and that host coral sometimes goes off. The coral spits out those symbiotic partners and it's very difficult for them to survive because they've lost their main source of food. Unfortunately, anywhere you have humans, corals tend to suffer, and that's because all of the activities that we do on land, things like building, things like discharging sewage, things like agriculture, those all affect the ocean. A country that's doing a very strong job of conservation is Palau. They saw a massive coral bleaching event in 1998 and realized that they were at risk from the changes occurring globally. So they started putting in place fisheries regulations, a marine park. They eventually put in a shark sanctuary, and now they have 80% of their water protected from any kind of fishing or mining. And what we know now is that the sort of days of hoping and wishing for those coral reefs to survive is over. This treasure will help us get through the next era of development as long as we're just kind enough and wise enough to be sure that they all come along together with us into the future, safely and protected.
The biggest impact of climate change to coral reefs is due to increasing sea surface temperature. So as CO2 builds up in the atmosphere, the air and the water warms. And so we've actually already seen warming of about 0.5 to 0.7 degrees Celsius across the world oceans, surface oceans. And this means a lot to coral reefs, actually, because they are an animal that lives what we call really close to their thermal tolerance. And so they have a very small range of temperatures at which they do best in. And temperatures of even 1 degree Celsius above the warmest temperature they see in the summertime can actually cause significant stress.
Rising temperatures throughout the global seas in coral reef ecosystems means the proliferation of more diseases. It means things like coral bleaching, the death of corals due to basically overheating, and then this notion of ocean acidification. These reef-building corals can no longer really build the hard structures due to this change in ocean chemistry.
The problem now is that there's so many of these different threats, and then you overlay the threat of climate change with the sea surface temperature increase, with ocean acidification. And the reefs are less healthy in general, and so it's harder for the reef then to recover from these other events or stresses. The biggest thing that we can do to stop the threat of climate change to coral reefs is to stop putting as much carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, to actually stop the warming we're seeing. There are things that we can do locally to improve resilience of reefs. And so the Coral Reef Conservation Program's approach is one of science and research to better understand impacts of climate change to coral reefs, and then using that information to build tools and products for managers to better understand reef resilience and how to increase the health of their reefs and what actions they can take on the ground. And then also to assist in education of stakeholders, of those people who use the reef, so that we're using the reefs as smartly as we can. If we address carbon emissions and we are able to stabilize the temperature changes that we're seeing, I think that we're still at a point where reefs can become healthy and flourishing again.